Today, we have some honored guests who cannot be with us, so we remember them this way. Gentlemen, please uncover. Please direct your attention to the table in front of the podium. This table is set for those who cannot be with us today, those who gave their all for the sake of our country. Some fell in anguish and are resting on foreign soil. Some, we know, were captured but were not released to rejoin their loved ones. Some simply disappeared. They may be lost from our fold, but they are not forgotten. The table is small, set for only one. It symbolizes the frailty of a lone individual against many oppressors. The tablecloth is white for the purity of their intentions in responding to their country's call to arms. The single red rose represents the families who kept the faith awaiting our comrades' return. The red ribbon tied so prominently on the vase is reminiscent of the red ribbons worn by thousands bearing witness of unyielding determination to demand a proper accounting of our missing. The slice of lemon on the plate reminds us of our comrades' bitter fate. The salt sprinkled on the plate reminds us of the countless volunteers shed by their families as they wait. The glass is inverted, for they cannot toast with us tonight. The chair is empty, for they are not here. The American flag reminds us that many of them may never return and have paid the supreme sacrifice to ensure our freedom. The candle is reminiscent of the light of hope, which lives in our hearts to illuminate their way home, away from their captors and into the arms of a grateful nation. The Bible reminds us to continue to pray for the Supreme Commander, that all of our comrades will soon be back within our ranks. Let us remember and never forget their sacrifice. May God watch over them and protect them and their families. In our frivolity this day, let us not forget our comrades who are currently in captivity and those who were never found, for I guarantee you, they have not forgotten us.